cars, trucks, trains, steam shovels. My friends and I love them, and we use them to build roads and construct buildings. But some time ago, I decided there was something missing. I told my dad that for us to be real building contractors, we needed two more toys, a hoisting tower and a cement mixer. Later, my dad came home with a cement mixer. He had made it in his factory, where he makes all the construction toys my friends and I play with. By the way, I'm Arthur Lundahl, but everyone calls me Buddy L. That's what the toys are called, too. Bunny L. All Steel Playthings. Maybe you've heard of me, or rather the toys, and perhaps you're wondering how a line of toys was named after a little boy like me. Well, it started with my father, Fred Lundahl. He was an engineer, which meant he designed and made things. While working for the Rock Island Railroad, Dad decided to start his own company, the Moline Press Steel Company. He opened a factory in East Moline, where he made steel parts for trucks and farm implements. Sometimes, Dad would make things out of metal scraps from the factory. In the winter of 1918, when I was 3 years old, he made a shield, like a windbreak, for my flexible flyer sled. I think that was the first toy he made for me. Like many parents, my dad got tired of my toys breaking. So he made me this truck for my 5th birthday. It was great, really strong, shiny, and just like the truck Dad made fenders for at his factory. He later told people that he did it more for recreation and with the thought of making something that wouldn't break, also interesting me in the work. Well, things weren't going well at the factory. Dad had a contract with International Harvester to make truck fenders, but production was slow, and Dad was running out of money. He had to find something else to make in his factory, or he would have to close it down. He took the truck he had made for me to Chicago to talk to the owner of International Harvester about letting him make this toy truck as a promotional or advertising item. When that idea didn't work, Dad went to the department stores to see if they would buy the toy truck. He also made several more models and sent them to toy buyers in New York City. He had gotten a few orders from Chicago and other places, and then an order came from FAO Schwartz, the big toy store in New York City. That's when Dad decided to make toys instead of truck parts. Dad wanted to make a toy that was strong and durable, so that kids could play with them long and hard without breaking them. He also wanted them to be just like the real trucks and equipment, so we could actually build roadways and bridges and buildings. In answer to an order from Pennsylvania, Dad wrote,
"It has been the aim of the writer to bring out a high-grade line of toys, at a reasonable price, endeavoring to give quality and value, and at the same time, bring out a line of some educational value as well as being indestructible."
Quality, durability, and realistic play. That's what Buddy L. toys were all about. And that's why they were so popular with retailers and parents, not to mention me and my friends. The company grew pretty fast because people really appreciated the quality of Buddy L. toys. One father from Cleveland wrote my dad,
"I purchased for my little boy a toy steam shovel manufactured by your concern and labeled Buddy L. I want to tell you how much I appreciate a concern that manufactures a toy as good as this. It is the best toy I have ever seen for a child, and it is a real pleasure to get a hold of one that is properly made as to material and workmanship."
I was 6 years old in 1922 when my dad started making toys full-time. They have three different toys: the original truck, which Dad called the Express Truck, a dump truck, and a steam shovel. He had ideas for 17 more toys. That year, he designed several Ford Model T cars and trucks, a steak truck, and two construction derricks. It was fun being the son of a toy maker. Saturdays were special because I spent part of the day at the factory. I saw the new toys as they were made, and I played with the finished ones. I never owned all of the models of toys that Dad made, but I probably played with them all down at the factory. In 1922, Dad started advertising the toys all across the country in toy buyers' magazines, and he used kids in the advertising photographs. The advertising people even wrote a book called The Story of Buddy L, about how Dad created the toys for me and my friends. In the back of this book was a photo of me, my friends, and my toys all lined up by the garage at home. It was neat thinking that kids all across the country would see me and my friends and play and build things with the toys Dad made. In 1926, Dad started making the biggest, most elaborate of the Buddy L toys, the Outdoor Railroad. They made a special setup behind the factory to take advertising photographs of the train. Dad asked my friends and me to be in the photos. When we saw it, we thought it was wonderful. Besides the two trains, they had a farmhouse and a depot and other trucks and cars on roadways crossing the tracks. I liked it so much that Dad made a similar setup in our backyard. My dad dreamed of making children's dreams come true by creating toys that were strong, durable, and realistic. He realized his dream. With Buddy L Toys, kids could do the same work that grown-ups do with the real thing. We built roads and buildings. We could make fires in the fireboxes of the train engines, cement mixer, and steam shovels. The pumper fire trucks and the tank and sprinkler trucks squirted water up to 30 feet. With Buddy L Toys, a kid could be a real contractor, train engineer, or fireman. Now, that's what I call toys that work.